joining us from New York, Fox Sports Radio host on Saturday, Steelers-Giants Super Bowl, Plaxico Burress. All right, Plaxico, you've played in that city. It's finger-pointing time in New York. I'm pointing fingers at the Giants. I say it's Eli. What say you? What's the problem?
It's a culmination of things right now, and it doesn't look good, doesn't feel good. It's a culmination of things. You can't run the football right now. You can't protect Eli, so he's erratic in the pocket. You have no Odell Beckham Jr., so the defenses don't respect anybody on the edge to beat man-to-man coverage, and they're getting eight in the box in the run game. And it just looks bad from an offensive standpoint. We have to get somebody out there who can you know, beat man-to-man coverage. And so the defenses respect somebody. And I don't care who your quarterback is or how good he is. If you can't protect him, everybody's going to look bad.
0-2 in 2007, you won the Super Bowl. Right. Go back to 2007. You were 0-2, and you were facing a divisional opponent. Now, I mean, obviously, you couldn't have predicted Super Bowl. But when you were 0-2, that week in the locker room, what was the message, Plax?
There's nobody we can look at but us. You know, our back's against the wall. It's a must-win game going into week three. We were playing a division opponent, just like we just like 10 years ago that the Giants are facing this weekend, going down to Philly. And we played as hard as we possibly could, and it came down to us making a goal line stop. If you go back and look at that play, it is one of the biggest plays in New York Giant history for that franchise, the ownership organization, because if you look at that game, it completely turned our season around. And then we went on to win 11 straight road games after that. And we just rode that wave after that game, finished the break at 6-2. And like I always say, man, the rest is history. But they can't look at anybody but themselves. I've never started a season off 0-3. I hope that they don't. The Philadelphia Eagles just lost last week to the Kansas City Chiefs, so they're going to come out and play hard. And it's going to be a dogfight down in Philly.
Everybody's got a loss in that division. So you were in New York Monday night commemorating the Super Bowl team. And it's funny. We have the play-by-play. I want to play. This is Joe Buck making the call with Troy Aikman, the Super Bowl. So let's play the moment in that Super Bowl first. Here we go.
Okay. Pressure from Thomas off the edge. Eli Manning stays on his feet. Airs it out down the field. It is caught by Tyree.
Oh, my God. This ball's thrown, and Tyree just goes up for it like a basketball player. Harrison trying to knock it down. And Eli, man, I don't know how he got out of there. I thought he was on the ground, and then he came out of the pile and just slings it.
By the way, Plax, you were there. When did you realize he caught it?
I saw him catch the football, but I didn't see the helmet part of it until after the play. The crowd absolutely went crazy. They erupted. I looked up at the Jumbotron, and I noticed that David Tyree managed to catch the ball and palm it, you know, on the back of his helmet. And I was like, oh, my greatness. So I went over and I grabbed him, and I was like, oh, my gosh, man, you just saved the Super Bowl. And he looked at me like he had absolutely did nothing. And you look at it 10 years later, it's arguably one of the greatest plays in Super Bowl history. And the fact, David Tyree absolutely ran the wrong route on that play. Hey, that's what makes it, you know, so funny. You look back at it. And if you look at the play, if Rodney Harrison just tries to upend David Tyree, I don't think he ever makes that play. But knowing Rodney Harrison, being a ball hawk his whole career, if he gets that pick, he knows that he's going to be the interception leader in the postseason. So he goes for the football and instead of trying to upend David Tyree, and it's one of the greatest plays in history, all because Rodney Harrison wanted that pick.
All right, that's a great story. Let's shift to Ezekiel Elliott. He quits on an interception against Dallas. Every athlete I've brought on the show this week has had a different opinion. Eric Dickerson said, man, I quit on plays. I'm like, really? What did you make of that play and the reaction and your takeaway?
I mean, I'm a wide receiver, so I've had a few interceptions thrown my way. But being on the offensive side of it, your first reaction is to turn around and go tackle the guy. But, you know, when you walk off the field, it just shows a lack of effort. You know, we always say in the NFL that nobody should have to question your effort.
Right.
And to me, it just looks bad from a teammate standpoint. He's playing in front of probably the best offensive line in all of football. And so now all your teammates look at it and say, hey, man, you know, we're out here, you know, busting our tails, you know, so you can be Ezekiel Elliott, so you can be a star. And everybody's blocking hard for you, but you're not giving us the same in return.
Yes.
That's the message that it sends to me, to the players who are looking at it. But I hear all the players in the media during the week saying he's not that kind of guy. But when you put those kind of things on film, that's exactly what it looks like.
Yeah. Finally, is there a team in the NFC right now? Seattle's O-line struggling. Packers defense is struggling. And, you know, like, I think Detroit's kind of an interesting team. I think they can beat Atlanta this week. Is there an NFC team, Plax, you really like?
I like what Detroit is doing right now. I think Matthew Stafford is playing great. But everybody's talking about the Atlanta Falcons. But I'm going to have to go with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. I just don't think they're getting the respect that they deserve. Jameis Winston is coming into his own. Yep. They add DeSean Jackson, put him on the edge. He's a guy that can go down the field. Mike Evans is a big receiver. He's going to continue to make plays. And that defense has been stellar, you know, for the last 2 years. They hold NFL team to 20 yards rushing. I don't care who you're playing against in the NFL. It's hard to hold a team to 20 yards rushing, and they did that. I think the defense is fast. Jameis Winston has total control of that offense. And looks like his team is rallying behind him. They respect him. They have a great defense. And I just think that at the end of the season, we're going to be talking about the Tampa Bay Buccaneers as being one of the premier teams in the NFC.
I'm looking behind you right now. Are you at the Major League Baseball Network right now?
That's what it looks like. I'm like, hey, man, we're going to talk about football, and I'm here in the baseball, you know, building. But it's all good, baby. As long as I get to you and get my point across, it's all good, Colin.
Plaxico, it's great seeing you, my man. One of my faves. Thanks, buddy.
All right, thanks, man.
All right.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe here to get the latest from the show. Also, be sure to check out more of the best clips from The Herd or go watch a few segments from the newest show on FS1, First Things First, with Chris Carter and Nick Wright.